Hello and good morning to all. Am I audible to you? Am I audible to you? Good morning to all. So we will start our today's online session. Let me share with you the study material of today's lecture. Hello, the screen is visible to you? Whether the screen is visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So you can see on the screen, unit number 3. Today we are going to start our unit number 3, that is the structure of the process. The actual title of the unit is, you can see in the syllabus, what is the title of the unit? The structure of the process control and process scheduling. Okay, let me first of all show you the actual syllabus content of this unit. Okay, so I will share the syllabus first of all. So here it is, you can observe on your screen the unit number 3. What is the title of the unit number 3? The title is the structure of the process, process control and process scheduling. Okay, so now after completing the 5 subsystem, okay, unit number 2 is what? The introduction to the kernel and the buffer cache. Introduction to the kernel and the buffer cache. There we have seen the 5 subsystem and the process control subsystem and the buffer cache. Now in unit number 3, we will see the process structure and the process control and process scheduling in detail. Okay, so what are the content of this unit? You can see on your screen in the syllabus, the articles are process, state and transition, layout of the system memory, context of the process, saving the context of the process, manipulation of the process address space, flip, process creation, signal, process termination, awaiting the process termination, invoking other program and the process scheduling. Okay, so these are the Hello. Now my voice is clear. My voice is clear now, audible. Am I audible clearly? Can you listen me properly? The structure of the process control and process scheduling is the title, and where initially we were discussing the content of the unit number 3. My dear student, kindly. I think that only Rohit, you are having a problem. Other students are also having the same problem. Voice is breaking or you are not audible. Rohit Kunte, you are sending the message that my voice is low, but other students are saying that the voice is clear. Am I audible clearly? Rohit Kunte, you give the answer. Rohit Kunte, unmute your mic. Unmute your mic and speak with me.
Hello.
Am I audible to you?
Sir, you are audible, but voice is very low.
But other students are not showing the same problem. Am I audible clearly? Give me the answer. Am I audible clearly? Can you listen me properly?
Yes, sir.
Hello, am I audible clearly? Rohit Kunte, can you listen me?
Yes, sir.
Now there is a problem, or no. shall we continue?
Continue.
Yes. Okay. Rohit Kunte, read the title of the unit. Read the title of the unit, Rohit. What is the title of unit number 3, Rohit?
The structure of process control and process scheduling.
Okay, read the content of the unit number 3. Read the content one by one slowly.
Process state and transition, layout of the system memory, context of the process, saving the context of the process, manipulation, the process address space, sleep process creation signal, process termination, awaiting the process termination, invoking other program, process scheduling.
Okay, very good. In that way, you are clearly audible to me, and I think that I am also audible to you. Now the problem is resolved.
Yes, sir.
Yes, very good. So now, see, we will start the unit number 3. So that is a good warm-up session conducted by Rohit Kunte initially. Okay, that gives some kind of energy to all of you. Yes or no? See here. So the structure of the process initially in the unit number two, we have seen the kernel, introduction to the kernel. So what is the kernel? Kernel is the program which is loaded into the memory. That is nothing but a bootstrapping. The process of loading the kernel into the memory, that is called as bootstrapping. Yesterday in the case study, we have seen what is meant by bootloader. So bootloader is a phenomena, or we can call it as a procedure. It is a procedure that is used to load the kernel into main memory. So that is called as bootstrapping. So while we are loading the kernel, okay, the bootstrapping process is going on. So now in unit number 3, we are going to learn many things about the process. Okay, so the structure of the process, we will see what is the structure of the process, we will see the process control and the process scheduling. Okay, and various articles are there that one by one we will see. I have prepared the e-notes of this unit number 3. Today we will see the lecture with the e-notes, and then from tomorrow, from next lecture, we will see the content on the PPT. Okay, so now what I will do, I will share the e-notes with you. Okay, see here now the e-notes are shared. Okay, you can see it on your screen. Okay, now the structure of the process. Structure of the process. So first question is that what is the process? We all know what is mean by process. Okay, what is the process? Can anybody unmute the mic and tell what is mean by process? What is the process?
It's instance
of program. Okay, so it is the instance of the program which is in execution. Very good. So it is the instance of the program. Now we know that what is mean by instance, what is the program, how it is executed, how it is loaded into the main memory, what is the region table, what is the text region, what is the data region, what is the stack region. Okay, all these things we have seen related to the process in unit number 2. Okay, so you might remember, or you have to remember, that what are the data structure of the kernel. What are the data structure of the kernel?
So there is per process region,
there is region table, and there is U area table, process table, and the main memory. Okay, voice is clear to everybody? Am I audible? Okay, so the all these things related to the process that we have seen earlier in the unit number 2. So usi ka reference lekar abhi hame unit number 3 padhna hai. So unit number 2 mein humne data structure padhe the, data structure related to the process control subsystem. Is unit mein abhi hum process detail padhne wale, detail. So first article is structure of the process. So everybody know that process is the instance of the program which is in execution. Okay, so instance may be anything. Instance may be anything, like you can say that resource is a one instance. Okay, user is a one instance. Then a process creation is the one instance. Many things are there, and that is together we know that it's called as the process which is in execution. Process which is in execution. Okay, so now see, the kernel has a process table. You can read the first paragraph in the notes. The kernel has a process table where it stores the state of the process and other information about the process. Okay, the information of the entry and the U area of the process combine the context of the process. Okay, my dear student, see, what is this actually? The kernel load the process, okay, into the main memory with the help of data structure like process table is there. Okay, the process table where it stores the state of the process. Now what is the state of the process? What is the state of process? Can anybody give the answer? What are the state of the process? What are the state of the process? Earlier in the unit number 2 we have seen what are the state of the processes. What are the state of the process? Can anybody give the answer? What are the state of the processes? User, kernel running, user ready to run, termination. Okay, so if you see the diagram, initially in the unit number 2 we have seen one diagram. There are three circles and they are connected to each other, like a Yuraj is saying that there is a user level, user running state. Correct, absolutely right. There is a kernel running state, and then while the program is running in the kernel running state, then interrupt can occur. Okay, if you remember the diagram, interrupt can occur and the process can go into the sleep state also. So when the process go into the sleep state, then what happen? Then actually the context switch is permissible. Context switch, we know the what is context switch. Again, in this unit, we are going to learn the context switch. So context switch is permissible. Context switch, the context of the process will be saved. Some information related to that process will be saved in the memory. Okay. And then again, when the process is wake up, then what happens? The process is going to the ready to run state. So that is the state of the process. State is nothing but the behavior of the system. So state in this case of processes is nothing but the behavior of the process. Process kya kar rahi hai? Process kaun se state mein hai? That is nothing but the process state. Now, my dear student, the article that we are going to learn in unit number 3, that is process, state and transition. So how the process can change from one state to another state, that is called as process state transition. Okay, many things are there to learn and understand that everything we have to learn with respect to kernel and its data structure. Okay, kernel and its data structure. So now you see the process, state and transition. Okay, so now you can see on your screen there is a complete set of process state is given. So maine aapko kaha tha ki ek bahut badi figure bhi hai aapko unit number 2 mein maine dikhaya tha ki there are only 3 circles, user running, kernel running, then the sleep ke sleep ko jane ke baad wo context switch permissible, and then when it is wake up then ready to run state. So what I will do, I will just share that PPT with that figure with you so that you can remember what are the state of the processes that we have seen in the unit number 2. This is there. I have just opened it. Now what I will do, I will share that with you so that you can remember what we have learned in unit number 2. Here, now this is that figure, the process, state and transition. So you can observe in this figure there is a user running is the first state, and whenever the system called or the interrupt occur, then the kernel running state is there. Process can switch from user running to the kernel running, and then when the sleep execution, sleep system call is executed, then process goes to the context switch permissible state, and when wake up system call is occurred, then the process goes into the ready to run state, and again from ready to run state the process can be scheduled for execution. Okay, in between that there may be an interrupt, and then the interrupt service routine will executed. So this is a state, process state we have seen in the unit number 2. Now isi ko abhi aapko thoda sa elaborate karna hai. Okay, in the unit number 3 aapko detail padhna hai ki what are the states and what are the state transition took place when process changed from one state to the other state. Okay, that we are going to learn in the article number 1 in unit number 3. Okay, so now what I will do, I will again open the PPT or the notes of your unit number 3. Okay, here it is. Here, structure of the process. Now a complete state of the process state is written here. Complete state, there are 9 state of the process state, 9 state of the process state you can observe on your screen. Okay, so what are that? This is, first one is the process is executing in the user mode. That we know, the process is executing in the user mode. Second is the process is executing in the kernel mode. Okay, that also we know. Now third one is the ready to run state. Ready to run state, that means what? The process is not executing but is ready to run as soon as the kernel schedule it. Okay, ready to run, ready to run जो state 3 number की है उसका meaning क्या है? The process is not executing, but is ready to run as soon as the kernel scheduled it. Okay, that is nothing but third state, ready to run. Now, fourth one is, you can read there, slipping in memory. So what is this slipping in memory? The process is slipping and resides in main memory. That means a slip system called execute. Okay, the process can slipping, you know what is mean by slipping. Okay, what do you mean by slipping? What is a slipping? Yes, Rohit Kunte, can you tell me what is mean by slipping? Rohit, are you there? Can you give answer? What is mean by slipping
the
process? What is mean by slipping?
Slipping means process is wait for some time behind the background.
In the background. You are giving a answer. I can add in that answer that actually process is slipping. Rohit said that process is waiting. So what is mean by waiting? So normally this is called as the process is suspended. Okay, waiting is also correct. Waiting is also correct. So Rohit said that the process can wait for a certain amount of time. Why the process can wait? Rohit, can you tell why the process is waiting? Why the process is waiting? Any reason why the process can wait?
If CPU allocates some resources to other process, then it stops some processes for wait in background.
Yes, correct. Yes, it's a good answer. The CPU is giving resources to other process. Giving means allocating. Okay. Resources is given or allocated to the P1, then P2 has to wait. So that is nothing but a waiting state. So whenever the process go under waiting state, so that is called as a process is under waiting state. That is not slipping state. That is not slipping state. Waiting state. Okay. So rather we can say that a process can go into the sleep state whenever the process is suspended for a time. Okay, suspended. Why the what do you mean by suspension? Suspension means the process can delay its execution for a certain amount of time. Okay, different activities will take place whenever the process goes into the sleep mode, and different activities will be take place whenever the process goes into the waiting state. So that is what I want to clear to you, that waiting state is different and sleeping state is different. That we will clear in the successive sessions. So that means a process is sleeping and resides in the main memory. Where it is sleeping? It is sleeping in the main memory. Main memory means it is already executing by the kernel. Main memory mein agar wo sleeping state mein hai, so that means the process is executing by the kernel and suddenly a sleep system call occurs. Suddenly. So that is one difference you keep in your mind. A process is executing in the kernel mode. Okay, the process is executing in the kernel mode and a sleep system called occur. That means a process is sleeping in the main memory. Okay, it resides in the main memory. Now you can see what is number five on your screen, that is ready to run but in swap space. Okay, so ready to run, but it is in swap space. What is the meaning of this? Here, I will elaborate this sentence. The process is ready to run, but the swapper must swap the process into main memory before the kernel can schedule it for execution. So here in bracket, it is written. It will be covered later because right now you will not understand what is mean by swapper and what is a swap space. But briefly, brief explanation main dena chahta hu yahan pe, what is mean by ready to run but in swap space. So there are a swapper process. Okay, that is a very good question. What is mean by swapper? What are the list of the swapper processes? Dear students, see, I will give the one answer. Process zero, that is mean the root process. Okay, root process. तो मैं एक एग्जांपल देता हूँ, रूट प्रोसेस, प्रोसेस जीरो हुज आईडी इज पीआईडी इज जीरो, सो जीरो मीन्स इट इज अ रूट प्रोसेस. रूट प्रोसेस इज अ स्वैपर प्रोसेस, स्वैपर. ओके, सो अ प्रोसेस मीन्स अनदर प्रोसेस इज रेडी टू रन, बट अ स्वैपर मस्ट स्वैप द प्रोसेस इन टू मेन मेमरी बिफोर द कर्नल कैन शेड्यूल इट टू एग्जीक्यूट. ओके, so p1, suppose I will give you the example, p1 is ready to run. Okay, agar p1 ready to run state mein hai, so it requires a swapper, it requires a swapper so that that process p1 can brought into the main memory and kernel can schedule. Ki swapper ki zarurat padti hai, swapper is nothing but a root process here, aur swapper ki zarurat to padti hai, lekin uske sath स्वैप स्पेस की भी जरूरत पड़ती है. स्वैप स्पेस, ओके, थोड़ी सी जगह चाहिए मेन मेमोरी में, स्पेस इज रिक्वायर्ड. दैट इज नथिंग बट अ स्वैप स्पेस, एंड द स्वैपर प्रोसेस विल ब्रॉड दैट पी वन इन टू द मेन मेमोरी एंड कैन शेड्यूल्ड इट फॉर एग्जीक्यूशन. जैसे मैं कह रहा था शुरू में कि आप अभी इस यूनिट नंबर थ्री में थोड़ा सा डिटेल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द प्रोसेस पढ़ने वाले, डिटेल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द प्रोसेस. दैट मीन्स process is ready to run, but it requires a swapper process that will brought the process into the main memory and it also have a swap space. So that thing we will discuss in the successive sessions. But the fifth number state is ready to run state. Now sixth one is there. So read the sixth one. What is the slipping in the swap space? Now see, slipping in the main memory. Char number ki kya thi? Char number ka tha. Slipping in the main memory, and the sixth number kya hai? Sixth number slipping in the swap space. Swap space, okay? Slipping का मतलब मैंने clear किया था. Slipping मतलब write delayed it execution. For some time, okay? Got it? So, dear student, see. Now the process can slip into the swap space also. Process can slip into the swap space. Okay? Swap space के बारे में तो बाद में देखने वाले हैं, लेकिन जैसे मैंने कहा कि swap space is the space. This is which space? Okay, here. So main memory रहती है. Main memory that is called as the primary memory. And then there is a secondary memory that is called as a hard disk, secondary memory. So actually the process need to brought into the main memory. Process ko main memory mein lana bahut zaruri hai. Agar humne matlab kernel ne process ko main memory mein laya tabhi process ka execution possible hai. Okay, abhi kya hota hai कि इमीडिएटली और हर बार, ओके, एवरी टाइम एंड इमीडिएटली द कर्नल कैनॉट ब्रॉट एवरी प्रोसेस इनटू द मेन मेमोरी. ओके, एक चीज आपको ये अंडरस्टैंड करनी है, व्हाट एवर आई एम सेइंग ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड. हर एक प्रोसेस को कर्नल इमीडिएटली मेन मेमोरी में ला नहीं सकता. क्यों नहीं ला सकता? बिकॉज main memory is currently utilized by other processes. Main memory limited hai, and main memory is currently utilized by other the processes, and we are saying that the every process need to brought into the main memory, but cannot brought every process into the main memory immediately. Then what happens? Why it cannot brought? Because the memory is utilized by other process. So in that case, required process. अभी तो क्या हो रहा है कि अभी तो आपको कुछ process execute करनी है. आपको मतलब kernel को. उस process को उसको main memory में लानी है. Then what will took place? Kernel remove the least recently used process, least recently used, no? kernel remove the least recently used process from the main memory and brought the required process into the main memory. Okay? So, abhi do operation yahan pe ho gaye. Remove the least recently used process. So, usse kya kahenge? Usse kahte hai swap out. Swap out the least recently used process from the main memory and brought the process into the main memory. Usse kahte hai swap in. Swap out and swap in. So this swap out and swap in will be take place with the help of swap space. Hello. Hello. Is there any problem? Hello. 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 Somebody unmute the mic and asking something. Okay. Is there any problem? Then you can unmute your mic and ask your questions. Otherwise, you can also write your problem in the chat box. Okay. So shall I continue? Okay, I will continue here. So that is the swap in and swap out. So the process can sleep in this swap space. That is nothing but the six number state. The process can sleep in the swap space. Now, see, actually, I will elaborate that sentence. The sleeping in the swap space. The process is sleeping and the swapper has swapped the process to storage to make the room for process in the main memory. Okay, this sentence is given. I'm having a textbook with me. I'm having a textbook with me and I am reading that sentence from that textbook. The same practice I used to do in the classroom also. Okay, so what is mean by sleeping a swap space? So see here, a process is sleeping and the swapper has a swapped process to secondary storage to make the room for other process in the main memory. And that is nothing but slipping a process in the swap. Okay. Slipping the process in the swap. Okay. Now you can see the seventh one. Sorry. Seventh one. So what is the seventh one written there? Preempted process. Preempted. Now you can read. Preempted means what? The process is returning from the kernel to user mode, but the kernel preempts it and does a context switch to schedule other process, very similar to the state number three. Okay. Preempted. Okay. So what is mean by preempted? It is very similar to the ready to run state, but it is given some explanation there. It means a process is returning from the kernel to user mode. Okay. Returning from kernel to user mode. But the kernel preempts it and does a context switch to schedule the other process. That is nothing but preempted. Okay. So preemption and non-preemption is the actual concept. What is mean by preemptive? Okay, here the actual preemptive, its meaning is that taken as a measure against something possible, anticipated or feared. Preventive, preemptive. Okay, so there are a process which are preemptive. Preemptive means a kernel. What the kernel is doing? Kernel preempts it and does the context switch considering that process. Okay, considering that process, kernel perform the context switch to schedule the process, another process. Okay, that is very similar to that of ready to run state. Okay, now eight number is newly created is the state of the process, not ready to run nor slipping. Okay, it is not slipping, it is ready to run. Okay, not ready to run nor slipping. This is the start state of all processes except process zero. Okay, so what is the state number 8? The process is newly created and is in the transition state. The process exists, but it is not ready to run, nor it is slipping. This state is the start state for all processes except process zero. So that is ready to, that is newly created process, newly created. Okay, are you getting what is the state number 8? State number 8, newly created process, which is not in ready to run state, not in slip state. Okay. So that is nothing but state number 8. Read the sentence carefully. Okay, and now the 9th number state is what? 9th number state, you can read the statement. The process executed exit system called and is in the zombie state. So, aapko yaad hoga, maine offline session ke dauran aapko pucha tha, so there is a zombie state. Okay, zombie, this word, it looks and it seems to be something dangerous. Okay, because we know that what is the meaning of zombie. Okay, but surely the same thing is applicable here, the zombie state. The process can go into the zombie state. Okay, so read the statement. The process executed the exit system call and it is in the zombie state. Okay, next line you can read. The process no longer exists, but it leaves a record containing an exit code and some timing statistic for its parent process to collect. The zombie state is the final state of the process. Okay. So again, we will see something about this zombie state later on when we will see the actual process state and transition. But these are the actual 9 states are there, which are there in the kernel or there are in the operating system under the structure of the processes. So firstly, now we will see what is the first one is the executing in the user mode, executing in the kernel mode, ready to run, slipping in the memory, ready to run, but in the swap space, slipping in the swap space, preempted. What is mean by preempted? The kernel preempts the process and does the context switch to schedule another process. And the 8th one is newly created, but that is not ready to run nor slipping. This is the start state of all processes except process zero. And 9th one, the process executed the exit system call and is in the zombie state. Zombie state is the last and the final state for all processes. And the process no longer exists, but it leaves a record. Some record is there. Record containing the exit code and some timing statistic for the parent process. So that is nothing but the 9th state. Okay, this thing is clear. Now I will show you the actual figure, actual diagram, that is the process state and transition diagram. Okay, so what I will do, I will scroll down. Okay, this is actual process state transition diagram. Okay, I think this is visible to everybody. This is the actual. Now you can compare the two figure. Jo kuch maine shuru mein aapko dikhaya tha, there are only 3 circles. Okay, and now you can see 3 or 4 are there. Okay, That means user running is the first, kernel running, asleep, and the wake up. Okay. And now you can see how many are there. How many circles are there? How many circles are there? Can anybody tell? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Total 9 circles are there. That means there are 9 state. 9 state of the processes. Okay. So first of all, I appeal to everybody, kindly see the figure. It's a very interesting and self-explanatory figure. You can get many things when you observe the figure clearly. Okay. First of all, observe the figure clearly. Everybody seen the figure clearly. Now you see there is a state. Number one, user running. A process is initially running in the user running state. Okay. The process is currently running in the user running state. Now suddenly what happened? Suddenly the system called and the interrupt occur. System called or the interrupt occurred. Okay. Now whenever the system called or the interrupt occur, then the process switch from user running to kernel running. User running to kernel running, you can see. Okay. And system called or interrupt occur होने के बाद, interrupt occur होने के बाद आप याद दे सकते हैं कि interrupt service routines will be executed and the process remains in the kernel running state. लेकिन system called execute होने के बाद process again goes to the user running state. Okay. And then next you can observe there. Now you can observe there. The next one is whenever the process is in the kernel mode, kernel running state. Okay. Whenever the process is in kernel running state, and then a preempt operation take place. Preempt. So what is a preempt? So kernel can preempt the process. So whenever the kernel preempt the process, then it goes to the preempted state. Okay. Preempted वाला है, the kernel can save the context of the process. Now we know what is mean by context of the process. Under preempted, the context of the process will be saved. Okay. Under preempted, the context of the process will be saved. Why it will be saved? Because later on when the process is ready to run, it can start from the actual context where it left. Okay. Here, see what happened. After a period of time, the system clock may interrupt the processor, and the process enters state is kernel running state. Okay, kernel running. When a clock interrupt handler finish the servicing clock interrupt, the kernel may decide to schedule the another process to execute. So the first process enter into preempted state and the other process execute. Now what happened in the preempted state? The state preempted is the same state as ready to run in memory. Okay, now you can observe the dotted line is given there. A dotted line in the figure that connects the two state emphasizes their equivalence. Okay, so seventh one is connected with third one with dotted line. That means they are equal. They are having a equal characteristic. Okay, preempted and this ready to run in the main memory are equal. Okay, so normally what happen whenever the context switch will take place, then the process are goes into the preempted state. Now after the completion of this preempted, you can see the process can goes for return to the user. Okay, and again it can redo for execution. But now from state number 2, you can exit system called occur exit. So exit occur hone ke baad kya hoga? Exit occur hone ke baad to process zombie state mein chali jayengi. Zombie state the process will terminate, exit, and it is the final state of the process. Uske baad final state matlab kya hai? After that the process cannot create the child process. So that is nothing but a zombie state. That is nothing but a zombie state. Okay, so then you can see from kernel running state, if a sleep occur, then it goes to the asleep in the memory. Okay, where swap out will take place. Swap out, then it sleep and swap, then again wake up will take place. Wake up, it goes to the fifth number state, ready to run and swap. And then in between this ready to run and swap, the swap out and the swap in, this activity will took place. Okay, yes, मैंने लास्ट लेक्चर में या आपको प्रीवियसली कहा होगा कि दिस स्वैप इन एंड स्वैप आउट इज द कंटिन्यूअस प्रोसेस. ये हर प्रोसेस के लिए होती है. ओके, ये स्लिप 4, 6, 5, 3, ये जो आपको स्क्वायर दिखाई दे रहा है यहाँ पे स्क्वायर 3, 4, 6, 5, दिस स्टेट ट्रांजिशन विल टेक प्लेस फॉर नियरली एवरी प्रोसेस. हर बार ये होता है स्वैप इन स्वैप आउट वेकअप स्लिप वेकअप. All these things are regularly took place for every process. And then you can see number 8 is shown there. 8. So 8 ko input kya hai? What is the input to 8? That is fork. So fork means a process is newly created. So actually ye diagram ka starting aapko yahan se karna hai. Yahan se. Okay. For every new process that is created by fork system call. Okay. That is first of all the process will be created. If the process is having enough memory hai to ready to run state. Okay, it goes for ready to run and then it's scheduled for execution by the kernel and it is under kernel running state. Agar after creation of the process is not having the enough memory. See here, after creation of the process, if the process is not having enough memory, then it goes to the state number 5. Okay, where the swap in and swap out will take place. Swap in and swap out will be take place and then again it is ready for execution. So that is a state transition for process state transition diagram. Okay, now our time is finished. What I will do, I will take your attendance. And today also we are having one more lecture in afternoon session at 1:30. There we will continue the same thing. Okay, so before leaving the meeting, kindly give your attendance. I will call the roll number and those who will give the attendance, they can in the meeting. Okay, so roll number 82, 83 is there, 84
present sir,
85
present sir,
86
present sir,
87, 88,
present sir,
89,
present sir,
90,
present sir,
91,
present sir,
92,
present sir,
93,
present sir,
94,
present sir,
95,
present sir,
96,
present sir,
97,
Present, sir.
99.
Present, sir.
100.
Present, sir. 99.
100 is there? 100 present?
Present, sir.
99. 101.
Present, sir.
102.
Present.
103.
Present.
104.
Present.
105.
Present.
106. 107.
Present, sir.
108.
Present.
109.
Present, sir.
110. 11.
Present, sir.
12.
Present.
13. 14.
Present, sir.
15.
Present, sir.
16.
Present, sir.
17. 18. 19.
Present, sir.
Present, sir.
18 is there. 18.
Yes, sir.
20.
Present.
21.
Present.
22. 23.
Present.
24.
Present.
Present.
26.
Present.
27.
Present.
28.
Present.
29.
Present, sir.
30.
Present, sir.
31. 32.
Present, sir.
33.
Present, sir.
34.
Present, sir.
35. 36.
Present, sir.
35. 35 present.
Yes, sir. Present, sir.
37. 38. 39.
Present.
40.
Present.
41.
Present.
42. 43.
Present.
44.
Present, sir.
45.
Present, sir.
46. 47.
Present, sir.
48.
Present, sir.
49.
Present, sir.
50.
Present, sir.
51. 52.
Present, sir.
53.
Present, sir.
54.
Present, sir.
55. 56.
Present.
57.
Present, sir.
58.
Present, sir.
62. 152.
Present, sir.
153. 176. 77. 78. 79. 80. 81. 82, 83, 84. Anybody remain?
98, 83 is present.
83 is present. Okay. 83 is not in.
98.
Just a minute. 83. 83, you are the first. 83.
155.
One by one. After 83, 90, what is
98.
98. 98. Then 155. 146 Varma Krishna. Anybody remain? Okay. Thank you very much.